Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, A Guide for Nursing Students. In this video, we'll discuss regarding changes in the fetal circulation at birth. Okay, so if we need to study changes in the fetal circulation, first of all, we should know regarding fetal circulation. Already, I have uploaded a video regarding fetal circulation, so I'll give the link in the description box for reference. Okay, here we should know the special structures in the fetal circulation. Here first structure is umbilical vein. Umbilical vein carries oxygenated blood from the placenta to the fetus. Next structure is umbilical arteries. So umbilical arteries carries deoxygenated blood from the fetus to the placenta. Next structure is ductus venosus, and it's a shunt. So it connects umbilical vein and inferior vena cava. The fourth structure is foramen ovale. It shunts blood from right atrium to the left atrium, bypassing the lungs. The last structure is ductus arteriosus. So it shunts blood from the pulmonary artery to the aorta, bypassing the lungs. Next, we'll see what happens in the fetal circulation at birth. Okay, so as we all know that before birth, the baby is completely dependent on placenta and fetal lungs are filled with the fluids. Right, so immediately after birth, normally what we will do, we will clamp and cut the umbilical cord, and at this point what will happen, the placental connection or the blood flow will lose or stops. So the baby starts independent respiration here. Okay, so when the baby starts this independent respiration or breathing, the lungs will be filled with oxygen. So due to the entry of oxygen into the lungs, what will happen, pressure in the pulmonary artery decreases and circulation to the lungs increases, right? So the main changes which occurs due to the cessation of placental blood flow and the initiation of respiration. Okay, here we will discuss one by one what are the changes or what will happen in these five structures. Here we will see what happens in the umbilical artery and umbilical vein. So we know that before birth, the blood will be flowing through this umbilical artery and umbilical vein, right? So but after birth, what will happen, the cord will be ligated. So here cord will be clamped and cut. Due to that ligation, what will happen here, thrombosis formation will occur in the umbilical cord, and also the oxygen content or oxygen tension in the blood vessels will be reducing. Due to these two reasons, what will happen, the umbilical cord or umbilical artery slowly it will be closing. So here two types of closure we can see, that is functional closure and anatomical closure. Here the functional closure is instantaneous, that is immediately after ligature this functional closure will occur, and anatomical closure takes about 2 to 3 months for complete obliteration. Okay, so it is due to the fibrosis of the lumen by intimal proliferation. Okay, so after obliteration, so here we can see in this is after birth and this is before birth. Okay, here there is no placental connection, here these are arteries, and here instead of that particular artery we can see ligaments. After obliteration of umbilical artery, it will be forming into lateral umbilical ligaments. Next, closure of umbilical vein. The reason is same, but it will take some time for the obliteration of this umbilical vein. It will take more time than umbilical artery. After obliteration, it will become ligamentum teres in our body. So this will be in the form of ligament. Next one is closure of ductus venosus. Okay, so here we can see the connection between umbilical vein and the inferior vena cava. Here it will be connecting. Okay, so what will happen here, due to the obliteration of this umbilical vein, the blood flow toward ductus venosus will be decreases. Okay, so what will happen, that ductus venosus collapse and it will be forming into ligamentum venosum. So mostly it constricts in 3 to 7 days. Okay, we will see the closure of foramen ovale. So foramen ovale, where it will be located, it's a shunt between right atrium and left atrium. You know that the ductus venosus, it will be constricting and it will be obliterating. So due to that, the oxygen tension or the pressure in the inferior vena cava reduces. Due to the decreased pressure in the inferior vena cava, the right side of the heart pressure will be reducing, and also due to the here the baby is starting to breathe. So here the lungs are filled with the oxygen. Okay, so when the lungs are filled with oxygen, the pulmonary resistance reduces and the blood flow through this pulmonary artery or pulmonary vein will be increasing. Okay, so due to that, more amount of oxygenated blood will be present in the left atrium than right atrium. Okay, so here the oxygenated blood in the left part, that is left atrium and left ventricle, will be more. Because of that, the pressure is more in the left chambers. Okay, but in the fetal circulation, how it is, right atrium and right ventricle is highly oxygenated blood, so the pressure is more here, right? So here after birth, it is just opposite. So when the pressure is more in the left atrium than right atrium, the functional closure of this foramen ovale occurs due to the pressure from this side. Okay, and anatomical obliteration, it occurs in about 1 year, and after that, that part, it will be forming in fossa ovalis. Okay, that is closure of foramen ovale. The next, closure of ductus arteriosus. Within few hours of respiration, due to increased oxygen tension, so it will be closing functionally. Okay, the functional closure occurs soon after the establishment of pulmonary circulation. Here what is happening means the muscle wall of the ductus arteriosus will be contracted and it will be obliterated. Okay, so anatomical obliteration, it takes about 1 to 3 months, and later it will become ligamentum arteriosum. Okay, these are the main changes which occurs in the fetal circulation at birth or after birth.